failures and successes. For those times when you follow all the rules, or when you just try something new, you do something sporadic, and your twist out is the bomb. You're gonna be grinning from ear to ear. You're gonna be taking selfies all day and sending them to your friends and your family members. You trying to go from store to store, walk around in the mall. You wanna pump your gas because you are feeling yourself. Be prepared for those days. And be prepared for days when you want to crawl under a rock, okay? Because trust me, there just may be 9 times out of 10, you're going to have a bad hair day or some bad hair days. You try to comb your hair a certain way, or you try a new style and it just does not look right, and you got to get out the door and go to work. I do have a tip on this one. Keep a goodie band, keep some bobby pins and or hair pins in your purse, in your car, at your desk, at work, in your pocket, wherever. Always know that I have a goodie band in my armrest. I don't care if you put them in your glove compartment, but always have something on hand. I've even gotten to the place where at work, not only do I have hair pins, but I just built my little emergency kit up. I have a small brush, I have some edge control, I have bobby pins, hair pins, a goodie band, scrunchies, decorative hair clips, a couple of flowers. I'm prepared. You hear me? I am prepared, because I've been in this long enough to know that some days you got to get out of the house and your hair is just looking a hot mess. I don't know how long you've been relaxing your hair, but just be prepared for the possibility of actually falling in love with your hair. Loving it, not even just liking it, preferring your natural hair. The possibility is there, it just might happen. So don't be surprised if, you know, the longer you stay natural, or, you know, 1 month in, 2 weeks in, 6 months in, you find yourself really liking the way your hair looks on your face, and you just may fall totally in love with your natural hair. The possibility certainly exists. And at the same time, I honestly feel that you should be prepared for the fact that you just might not like your natural hair. Just feel like,
it's not worth it. I don't like it. I don't like the way I look. It's just not working for me.
You can't do it yourself, or maybe you're finding it hard to maintain it.
That
just might happen. So I feel you should be prepared for it going either way. You may fall in love with it. You may want to learn more about it. Or you may just say, this is not for me. And I must say this because I have friends and family and complete strangers who I talk to, and some people just don't like the natural look. It's not working. If you get to that place and you feel like, I want to just relax my hair, get it over with and go on with my life, then go ahead and get a relaxer and go on with your life. Hair should not stress you out. There are too many things in this world to worry about, to be concerned with, and I feel hair should not be one. I should not be stressed out about my hair. Hair is so far down on the list. Do something with your hair, feel good about it, and move on. Hair should not be a holdup. I had a friend to actually text me and say, I had to turn in my natural hair membership card or something like that. Don't be mad with me. I'm like, girl, please.
Do you like it? Is your husband happy?
That's all that matters. Are you happy with what you see in the mirror? Are you comfortable? So I just had to insert that little piece in there. You know, if you have friends, you're gonna have friends, whether you're locked, straightened, relaxed, natural, whatever. They're your friends, they're your friends. But even if you do have people to turn on you, that has nothing to do with you. Be happy with your hair. So once again, be prepared for the fact that you just might not like it. And if you don't like it, it's okay. You can always go make an appointment with your beautician, hairstylist, whatever you want to call them, and go get yourself a perm. Before you jump into cutting all your hair off, or before you just, you know, be spontaneous and say, I'm just not going to perm my hair anymore, do some research, not only on natural hair.